CADASIL is a disease of the small arteries in the brain, usually starting with small infarcts in the brain around the age of 35, 40, 45. This progresses over the years so that they have progressively difficulties in walking, difficulties in moving, difficulties in swallowing, and then cognitive changes. Usually, in a mean of 20 years, this leads, unfortunately, to death after complete dependency and dementia.
Hello.
Hello, Chantal.
On s'embrasse.
Voilà, c'est une belle journée qui commence.
Oui, absolument.
Merci. It is in 1976 that I saw a 50-year-old man who I didn't know at that time, but was going to be Joseph, the first CADASIL patient.
Non.
Le 3, Antoine. OK. So we you can come in. 17. OK. This is exactly the same place where I was in 1976,
yeah?
When I first met Joseph.
My great uncle.
Your great uncle. Just after my residency, yes. I was a young assistant, and there he was with, as you know, a stroke, a very unusual kind,
yes,
of stroke. I asked him if he wanted to be included, yeah, in this trial of aspirin to prevent, yeah, another, yes, stroke,
yeah,
and he said yes. And so I followed him very, very, very regularly. At the beginning, Joseph was just a patient with whom we did not really understand what was going on. And I knew there was something strange in his story because he was young, he had no risk factors, no high blood pressure, no diabetes, he was not smoking.
My family is a family of farmers, and they were living in very difficult condition, being impaired, paralyzed, dying rather young. They had no medical help, no solution for the future.
I'm just impressed to be in this room where you met my grand uncle,
yeah,
but I can imagine how much it was difficult for him because we didn't know anything about this illness, yeah, and the risk we had.
Yeah. For many, many years I have followed Joseph, and in 1986 his daughter came to see me, and her brother came too, and we could see that they had the same deep infarcts and white matter changes as their father. So, you know, I knew at that time that this was a familial disorder, and we started to draw the family tree. And then by that time I had met Elisabeth Tournier-Lasserre, and she said, can I work with you on that?
Okay. Comfortable. So we can show the documents.
Okay.
Huh?
My family at the beginning of the 20th century. My grandmother and her sister, they both had inherited CADASIL mutation from their father. Of course, they were not aware of it.
Yeah, we did not know that at that
no.
time. If I remember right, she is the mother of Joseph,
the first patient. Yes.
So she is the mother. We were able at that time to contact the family members that had all agreed to come to Paris, and we could examine them, draw the blood for genetic study, and do, of course, the MRI, which was absolutely crucial. And it's on the basis of that that Elisabeth did the genetic study and found the location of the gene on chromosome 19. We knew this was an important finding, and we knew it was a disease of small arteries of the brain. So we decided that we should find an acronym for this disease, and I suggested the acronym CADASIL. Cerebral autosomal dominant arteriopathy with subcortical infarcts and leukoencephalopathy. Within 3 years, we gathered 33
families.
Other families. And at that time, Anne Joutel, she had been my resident in neurology, so at the beginning she was a clinician. And then after her residency, she decided to go into research, And she went to Elizabeth's lab, and then both of them found the gene NOTCH3. So this was already very important because it opened a new area of research.
Yeah.
What is the role of this gene in the development of the small vessel in the brain?
And just at the time, Hugues Chabriat did his thesis on MRI techniques, and particularly studying, of course, normal subjects and CADASIL patients already. And this is how he became very much involved in clinical research and correlation between MRI images and clinical research. And he has been working mostly on the clinical presentation of CADASIL, the cognitive changes in CADASIL, and all the correlations between the MRI changes and the symptoms.
Yes,
I think it's very helpful for us to have a dedicated team of researchers and doctors who are very accessible for our family. When our mother was ill, she could phone Professor Busser at home late in the night on her personal phone number. So this engagement, this involvement, this personal link with Professor Busser, Professor Chabriat, Professor Tournier-Lasserre, and Dr. Joutel, who are so enthusiastic, so generous with us, is just a very, very strong help for us, and also it gives us some confidence in the future.
We will share all these documents.
Oh, yes,
we will keep
yes.
the link.
Oh, certainly. Is there anything left for CADASIL research? Well, of course. I mean, the most important one is to find a treatment.
We're grateful.
Don't forget
oh,
this
yes,
one.
It's so precious. It's a treasure for me.
Okay.
Oh,
so
I was very happy to share this moment with you.
Professor Busser, particularly, is like family. And I'm sure she will get her objective, her aim of finding some solution.